that on that day the people will be given their books. Those who have done good will be given their books on the right hand. And those who have done otherwise have none to blame but themselves. And they shall be given their books on the left. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not make us from those who fail on that day. The temporary failures in this world sometimes lead us to do that which is in the displeasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in order to achieve success. And this is why we have so many people, the minute they are affected or inflicted with any negativity, they run to people who claim to know the unseen, whereas none knows the unseen but Allah. They run to those who claim to have solutions, whereas none have the solutions besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They run to those who engage in superstitious activity. Remember, superstition is very far from this religion of Islam. Islam is a very simple religion, straightforward, where the greatest link and the most powerful link you could ever develop is the link with your own maker. If you have strengthened that rope, there is no rope that you need besides that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to strengthen the link with Him. The less we link up with our own maker, the more we will link up with everything besides the maker. And for this reason, it's important for us to realize that whenever something has befallen us in terms of negativity, whether it is ill health, whether it is the death of a family member or a child, whether it is loss, we should never ever resort to anything superstitious. We should not go to people who promise us things in exchange for a little amount of money. And some might even do that for free. Remember something, we cannot sell our faith in our Maker for a short tuppence that will not get us anywhere. For a little bit of pleasure that might last a few moments, we don't want to sell our link with our Maker. وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ Remember, the Almighty says, turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in repentance, all of you believers, in order for you to achieve success. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضله فلا هادي له. I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger, the final prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I ask the Almighty to grant us benefit from the knowledge that he has given us, to benefit us from that which he has granted us, to make us from those who go out to seek beneficial knowledge, and at least to grant us the title of students of knowledge. For indeed, that is a very, very virtuous title if it is granted by the Maker himself. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept us to be from amongst those whose main aim in life is to please Him, and may He be from amongst those who is pleased with us at the same time. My beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, it is important that we are conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every khutbah or sermon that we hear, usually we will find the imam commencing with the warning or the encouragement, ittaqullah, be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We normally take this for granted, and sometimes we just hear it and we have the idea of what it means, but we sometimes forget to put it into practice in our own lives. And this is why it's important for us to think for a moment and to pause. Every single time we hear that reminder, what does it mean? What have I done before I came to the masjid today? And what am I planning to do as soon as I leave? Am I planning to engage in that which will displease Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Do I use my phone in a way that will displease my Maker? Am I in touch with those whom I am not supposed to be in touch with? Am I engaged in a relationship with the opposite sex in a way that I am not supposed to be? If that's the case, the only way to achieve the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is by becoming conscious of Him and putting an end to everything of that nature that will displease Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember, the warnings and the reminders that have got to our ears were never meant to miss our ears. So I will be asked, and so will you. We will be asked about the reminders. I will be asked of the reminder, and whether I put it into practice or not, and whether it was delivered or not. And yourselves, you will also be asked about the reminder. Did you hear it or not? And what did you do about it? So this is why we believe in the purest reminders which come from the Quran and the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. For indeed, besides that, we don't need anything. The reminders we have from our own Maker are more than enough for us. The problem with us is sometimes we tend to become oblivious of it because of our day-to-day dealings and because of the beautification of this world. We are not at all encouraging people to divorce themselves from this world. For indeed, part of the consciousness of the Almighty is to do dealings that are upright and to look after your family and to look after your needs. That is also part of the consciousness of your Maker. But remember, in the process, we don't want to achieve the displeasure of our Maker. And this is why we have uttered and we will continue repeating the fact that it's very important never ever to try and achieve something for our benefit whilst it is in the displeasure of our own Maker. The Almighty says in the Quran in Surah An-Naba, إِنَّ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ مَفَازًا حَدَائِقَ وَأَعْنَابًا وَكَوَاعِبَ أَتْرَابًا وَكَأْسًا دِهَاقًا. I invite you to open the pages of the Quran, whether it is later on today or at some point, and go through the passages of Surah An-Naba and see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has issued a warning and at the same time good news. A warning for those who displease Him, those who don't turn to Him, those who continue in the displeasure of the Maker, and good news for those who are conscious of Him. For indeed, for us, the true enjoyment is in the Akhirah, in the life after death. And this is why the Almighty says, for the muttaqoon, for those who are conscious of Allah, we have prepared paradise. And He describes a bit of it in that surah, and He describes much more of it in many other surahs of the Quran, as well as in the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. On many occasions, the Prophet Muhammad, may peace be upon him, has also warned us to be conscious of our Maker. And he says that indeed you will be meeting your Maker, and each one of you shall be communicating and talking to your Maker, answerable to your own Maker. No barrier between you and him in terms of speech. You will be talking to him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has confirmed this in the Quran as well. And this is why the moment we know that Allah is closer to us than we are to ourselves, as He says, وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says we are closer to man than he is, or we are closer to man than his own jugular vein, which means than he is to himself. Imagine someone telling you, Allah is closer to you than you are to yourself. He can take you away at any time and he can do whatever he wants. May we be from amongst those who prepare for the day we are meeting our Maker. If we'd like to achieve the consciousness of Allah, it is important as per the instruction of the Messenger, may peace be upon him. He says, increase the remembrance of that which destroys all lusts and desires that are unlawful. And what is that? Death. The moment you think of death and you think that you are going to die, which is very normal, it is normal on a daily basis to think that this is going to be my last day, to the degree that the Prophet, peace be upon him, says, when you are fulfilling your daily prayer, you should fulfill it in a way as though this is going to be the last opportunity for you to engage in prayer. Every prayer should be like that. This would mean that on a daily basis, at any moment, I should be conscious of death. And if I am conscious of death, it will help me to be conscious of my own Maker. And this is why one of the main points of taqwa is to continue remembering where you are heading and where the others have already gone and where we will ultimately be. May the Almighty be pleased with us. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu used to make mention of a statement, حَاسِبُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ قَبْلَ أَن تُحَاسَبُوا وَزِنُوهَا قَبْلَ أَن تُوزَنُوا. You should take account of your deeds before they are taken account of. And you should weigh them before they will be weighed. And this is referring to the life after death, or referring to the day of judgment. And this is part of consciousness of Allah. Weigh your deeds before they will be weighed. Take account of your deeds before they will be taken account of. In this world we have our own businesses where we take very good stock of what is happening. Why don't we take stock of our own deeds and the beauty of it? Where you have gone wrong, my beloved brothers and sisters, it is so beautiful. The Almighty says, just turn to me and I will delete whatever you have done in the past. I will delete whatever you have done in the past. Don't lose hope in my mercy. O my worshippers, the Almighty says, don't lose hope in my mercy. Allahu Akbar. He is the one who is most forgiving, most merciful. So let us turn a new leaf today and let us remember these reminders that come. They are the words of the Almighty, the words of the Messenger. It's important we take heed. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all benefit in the dunya and the akhirah. And may He make us from those who have excelled in the dunya and the akhirah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the best of this world and the next. May He make us from those who are conscious. Ya Allah, we ask You to benefit us all. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم آمنا في أوطاننا وأصلح أئمتنا وولاة أمورنا واجعل ولايتنا في من خافك واتقاك واتبع رضاك يا رب العالمين. We ask You to protect us in our lands. We ask You to protect our suffering brothers and sisters across the globe. We ask You to help us all, to grant us peace and stability, security. We ask You to grant us every form of goodness to protect us and our offspring. We ask You to grant us goodness in our homes, goodness in our businesses, goodness in our health. We ask You to grant us every form of goodness, and we ask You to make us from those who are successful in this world and the next. And we ask You to grant us paradise ultimately when You take us away. We ask You to benefit us in every single way. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وارحم موتانا وموت المسلمين وارحمنا إذا صرنا إلى ما صاروا إليه. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وأنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد والحمد لله رب العالمين.